But the most fundamental assumption of Lucas and Conati, or at least the one that in some sense is most problematic and yet fixable, is this idea that we can use that Taylor series approximation. So the idea of that Taylor series approximation is that we can make a small ramp estimate, that is a first order linear estimate, and then as things move a little bit, that'll tell us how things change. And we've gone over one method. We talked about nonlinear iterative refinement, so that if it's still the right model in terms of the point nearby is changing, but it's not linear, maybe it's quadratic or something, we use a bunch of linear successive approximations. But actually, that's not the problem that exists most often. The one that exists most often is that actually pixel motion is not small. And so you can't just assume that you can tell how things have changed by just doing a very local analysis. So to solve that, we have to do something called coarse-defined estimation. To illustrate what I mean, here's a simple example. So here you see on this one, on the left side, I have curves that have been shifted by only a small amount. So when I find one point value, the nearest match is actually the correct displacement. So if I actually fit a little slope through here, I can do my local estimate, and I'll eventually find the correct match. But over here, I've got a different situation. So there's one point. The nearest match will now be this red point, right? So it basically has just estimated the change to be that much, all right, where the actual shift, of course, is much, much more. All right, and so the estimated shift is too small. So the question is, how would you fix that? So let's take a look at this on a real picture. So here's an example on some real pictures. So this is two frames taken out of the MPEG garden sequence, and what you can see is that I've got one frame, and then in the next frame, the tree moves to the left quite a bit because the camera has moved to the right. And you can see the tree in the front is occluding the tree in the back. Okay, so question, do you think that this is a small enough motion to be able to run Lucas and Conati? No, look, there's a lot more than one pixel or a small number of pixel motion with a planar assumption between. I'm uncovering entire trees in the background, right? So the problem is, you know, how could we solve this, right? How could we eliminate this problem of large pixel motion? And I'm gonna show you with a single slide, you're gonna look at it, you're gonna go, aha, I get it. Ready? Now.
Aha! I get it.
What do you get? Okay, here's what you got. And the top left corner is the original sequence, all right? And you can see that the thing is moving a whole bunch of pixels. I don't know, maybe it's moving, let's call it 7. On the top right, you'll notice the picture is drawn the same size, but I've actually reduced the pixels in half. So now it says there's like 90 pixels across, right? Before there was something like 180. Well, gee, if I was moving 7 pixels before, now I'd only be moving 3.5 pixels. Ah, do it again. Now I've only got 45-ish pixels, bottom left-hand corner. Now, instead of moving 3.5, well, half of 3.5 is 1.75. Okay? That's still more than 1, isn't it? Yes. Okay? Well, cut it in half again. So now I have this picture on the bottom right. And if you look at that animation, you'll see you can sort of see it shifting within the pixels. It's actually less than a 1 pixel motion. Okay, it's a very blurry picture, and I had to make it really blow it up, and now you can actually see each pixel in there. But you can see that the motion is a sub-pixel motion. So basically what we want to do is we want to implement a motion recovery method that takes this coarse image and then iteratively, or I should say multi-scale-wise, goes to a finer and finer image.